All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Chad Peters. He's the CEO of Ridgeline Minerals. And Chad, it's great to see you again. How are you?
Yeah, thanks for having me, Steve. I'm good.
Good. So you've just dropped a news release talking a little bit about what's ahead in 2023, at least at the beginning part of 2023. And that is going to be some drill results because you've been pretty busy over the last little while in getting your projects moved forward. So I thought we'd go project by project because there's so much to talk about. So let's begin with SWIP. Just remind everyone about that, the partnership that you have with Nevada Gold Mines and where you're at.
Yeah, sure. No, we have been busy the last 2-3 months, but just like every other junior that you hear about, you know, programs are taking longer to get done and assays are taking longer to come through. So we wanted to do that update just to give some guidance for folks. So at our SWIFT project, that's our partnership with Nevada Gold Mines. We inked a $30 million US deal back in September of 2021. Pretty much what that requires is them to hit a minimum spend of $30 million to earn 70% of the project with a $4 million guarantee in the first 2 years, of which we're pretty confident they'll have blown through that in the first 15 to 18 months, I guess you could say here, which is really exciting. So they've drilled three holes at the SWIFT project, deep, wide-spaced holes, testing for the right structures, the right host rocks, which would hopefully then allow them to vector into higher grades and kind of the core of what we hope would be a mineralized gold system in the future. So what was really exciting is they actually, Barrick announced in their Investor Day presentation in early November, they actually made a point of highlighting the SWIFT project as a significant exploration play, that they're hitting significant alteration, anomalous gold. And I think that's that's really important to point out, right? Like big companies like that, they typically do not point out small things like that, you know, small exploration projects until they become a bona fide discovery. The fact that they're already pushing that as an important exploration project for them in the district is really exciting for us. So we can't wait to get assays out in the new year. And it'll be Ridgeline that'll be announcing those assays, is my understanding. So as soon as they're in through the lab, we'll get them out to market.
All right. Look forward to hearing about those. We should also mention your Selena project as well, where you've completed the drilling there also.
Yeah, Selena is our flagship. We honestly think we're onto a pretty significant CRD discovery. So this drill program that we were drilling was the first core program ever drilled on the project. So it's been all reverse circulation RC with what was historically our strategic drilling contract, which I've talked about for years, but we've actually used that contract up now. And this project's at a point where it's ready to move forward with core and start taking towards a resource. So we confirmed and twinned our best hole in the Chinchilla zone, which is our most advanced zone in our original discovery. And then we followed up with multiple shallow targets, the Juniper and Broken Egg target areas, going after shallow high grade oxide gold and silver. So we're going to have results. We'd hope to have that program done. Geez, we'd originally planned on having it complete by early November. We just finished it December 16th. The drill company showed up a month late. You know, that happens, scheduling and stuff like that. So Things dragged out. Now we're looking at having results in January and February of 2023. So between SWIFT and Selena, you're going to see multiple sets of press releases coming out with hopefully some exciting assays.
All right. We'll look forward to those again. Thought I'd give you an opportunity just the rest of 2022 and sort of setting you up, as you mentioned, obviously, lots of drill results in 2023, but you know, the projects you're looking at as well.
Yeah, we have a pretty large portfolio outside of those two projects. We've been pretty open about our Carlin East and Bell Creek projects. These are strategic assets that we're looking to partner to groups like Nevada Gold Mines or a Newcrest or any major looking to come in and drill deep, high risk but high upside holes in the Carlin trend. So those two projects we're currently working on options, you know, trying to move those forward. And then our Robert Gulch project, I'm really excited to get out and start drilling that with our backpack rig in probably the first quarter of next year. So that's an oxide gold play in Idaho. Reminds us a lot of the Black Pine deposit, same host rocks. It's already a proven oxide discovery with multiple drill holes into it. Now the big question is can we step out from that and start drilling, you know, on strike and down dip of this known discovery and show that there's room to grow. So that will be a big focus for us in the spring.
Wow. Sounds like you and I are going to be talking a lot in 2023 and very early as well. Lots of results to come. Chad, yeah. Congratulations on all of this. Exciting for you and exciting for the company as well. And have a great holiday and we'll talk to you in early January.
Yeah, same to you, Steve. Thanks.
All right. There's Chad Peters, the CEO of Ridgeline Minerals.